video is a how-to on how to make your own isolation headphones for about $25 or less. For years and years, I was looking for the best headphones to use for playing along with music, be it drum covers, be it just trying to practice on my own to hear the music loud and clear. And for a long time, I used headphones like this. This is the K-44. I believe these are the COS headphones. Nope, I lied. They're AKG. AKG headphones. They're really good. They're about 40 bucks. Fit over nice and good. It got rid of a lot of the sound. About 40 bucks. But it got rid of a lot of the sound, but it didn't isolate the exact CD quality sound that I wanted to hear out of this. Plus, it had a lot of bleed through of other sounds. Maybe good for studio headphones, but not good for isolating CD quality sound with loud music going on in the background. I've seen some people making videos have these kinds of headphones. This, I don't know, it's kind of a no-name headphone I had around. Come over like this. It's nice and snug. It gets the sound real close to your ear, but it lets a lot of extra sound in. Maybe good for taking on a jog. Not good for doing covers or with lots of room noise. Many people have these. These are your standard iPod headphones. Super comfy, but they let a lot of other sound bleed in too. Plus, you have to crank it pretty loud to be able to really hear the crisp sound if you have drums, if you have other instruments going on at the same time. You could buy noise-canceling headphones, super expensive. You could buy in-ear earbuds. I think there's some really, really expensive ones out there. My best alternative was this. Though these are pretty old, nasty looking, some low-profile earbud headphones. Not necessarily in-ear. They could be in-ear headphones if you'd like to use that, but these are low-profile earbuds. Combine that with your standard earmuff. If you're a shooter or if you're out at gun ranges, you know about these things. Good old earmuff. These ran me $9 at a local ammunition and gun store. These headphones, these little earbuds, I think these were Philips, got them at Walmart about $10 a while back. Grand total, $19. Now, the way that these have become isolation headphones for me is put these in regular. These come right over top, just like that. Looks super dorky, but it works. These earmuffs that I have here, they cut, I think, 25 decibels. It's awesome. The lows still have a little bit of a presence, but it just kills the highs. So nice for if you're playing really loud and you got your cymbals ringing, you got lots of sound going on, you're going to kill your ears if you're not careful. These will cut 25 decibels. And then with these earbuds in there, you're getting really, really crisp sound. So, on to the last part on why I talked about them being low profile. The thing with the earmuffs, it gives a nice area around your ear, but like the Apple standard headphones for iPods and such, there is this part right there that trails down. These would be an awesome choice, except for the fact that in your ear, this will bang into the side of the earmuff padding, and it'll make the earbud come out of your ear. Not really helpful when you're in the middle of doing a drum cover, doing a video, or you're jamming by yourself. Not good. Low profile earbuds, or if you can splurge on some in-ear headphones, low profile will prevent that. These have a little bit of an extra part here, but it's not enough to make it pull out of my ears. I find this alternative to isolation headphones or noise canceling headphones to be much more economical. Yeah, it looks a little bit more dorky, but the price is worth it, and the final result is great, and you save your ears. And that, and for me, that's the most important part of being a musician, at least for me right now. Got to save my ears. So thank you for watching. I hope this is informative. You make your own isolation headphones for about $25. Take care.